Christmas time at Sammy's workshops is usually all handmade gifts. This year, for my brother and his wife, and my sister and her husband, we're going to make a pair of table centerpieces from a pattern I found by Sweet Pea Designs. If this sounds like the kind of video you'd enjoy, please hit like, subscribe, and click on the alert bell to get notified of new videos being uploaded. Now stick around for a bit, and we'll look and see how these are made. Before we get to today's project, let's take a moment to talk about workshop safety. Be sure to read, understand, and follow all of the safety rules that come with both your hand and power tools. Knowing how to properly operate your tools and following these safety rules can significantly reduce the risk of damage and/or personal injury. And of course, there are no more important safety rules than to avoid loose clothing, long sleeves, and to wear safety glasses, hearing and respiratory protection as needed. Now let's get to today's project. Hello, you too. My name is Sammi, and welcome back to Sammy's Workshops. Today's project is to make a pair of table centerpieces from a design by Sweet Pea. Since I have two gifts to make, you'll see two different sets of fabrics in use here, one for my brother and one for my sister. Each table centerpiece needs six pieces. The Sweet Peas provides three different snowflake designs in three different sizes, 5x7, 6x10, and I believe a 7x12, when you buy the pattern. Now, Sweet Pea does things just a little differently than I normally like to do them. Their first step is a all-in-one tack down stitching step that tacks down the fabric and the batting. I like to do these separately. I'll stitch this out once for a placement stitch, then I'll put my batting down and stitch it down, backing up and restitching stitch number one. And then I like to trim the batting so that when I get to sewing pieces together, I don't have so much batting built up in the seam allowance. Then, of course, I'll stitch that outline stitch one more time in order to tack down the front fabric. That means I stitched that first step three times, one for the placement, second to tack down the batting, and the third one to tack down the fabric. Once that step is finished, then we're going to stitch out do the embroidery part. The first part is the cross stitch background. Then we'll do an outline stitch that goes around that to highlight the snowflake. I like to use a second color for this. When that is done, then there's a box outline stitching that goes around it, which in one case, in the one for my sister in the orange and yellow, I used I only used two colors. On the one for my brother, I actually used three colors here. Then the joint angle stitches at the top get stitched down. And lastly, we'll place the background fabric face down or good sides together, depending upon how you like the terminology, and we'll stitch the front and back together. The design is set up to leave a small opening at the top so that you can turn the piece right side out, which is, of course, our next step. At that point, I like to use a chopstick to push the corners out so they're nice and crisp. And then, of course, we're going to fold in the leftover at the gap and stitch it closed. Then we just lather, rinse, repeat to make five more. And, of course, since I'm making two of these, I'll do all of these steps again for another six sections. Then they all head off to the ironing board to press them flat before we start into stitching them together. I don't remember if the instructions actually said this, but I'm pretty sure they did. You want to stitch three pieces together, so you make one half of the table center, and then stitch the other half together, and then marry the two once it's done. Supposedly this makes the whole piece come out flatter, but I didn't find that happened so well for me. As you stitch each of the individual leaves or petals of this table center together, you'll find some lapel flaps, that's my term for them, which will fold back flat or iron back flat, and then I stitch them down, and then they're to be stitched down. You can hand stitch them or do what I did, which was to machine stitch them with a narrow 1/8 inch seam. Then again, I ironed everything flat again. Well, mostly. These did pull up a little bit in the middle, which will be okay if we use a candle in the center. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like, subscribe, and the alert bell to get notified of new videos being uploaded. I upload new videos every week on Wednesday, with some others in between as time and projects allow. You can also follow me on Facebook and Instagram. I have a website as well for patterns that I digitize and plans to download. I also have links to the tools and supplies I use if you want to use the same things I do. In fact, there'll be a link to Sweet Peas in the comments down below as well. All those other links will be there in the comments as well. That's all we have for this project. Thanks for stopping by. Do come again soon. Until next time, see ya.